and the prisoner of Azkaban. We have this beautiful Patronus. You are sharing the Dark Lord's thoughts and emotions. The Headmaster thinks it inadvisable for this to continue. He wishes me to teach you how to close your mind. Beautiful covers. And maybe just read the blurb on the back of each of the books one by one. Make this a nice, long, relaxing Harry Potter video. I also have all of the books in French. Not in like a box set, but I just collected them one by one. It won't be like a collection video like this, but I will follow up with that one, reading the blurb in French, and just like looking at the books. I have actually already done a Harry Potter collection, book collection before. It was a long time ago before I got this. I had all the books just different, sort of just like random. So this will be a three-part series, I guess. One will be this one, with these beautiful, beautiful books in this collection. Second will be a French-speaking one, which I'll probably speak in English and in French. And then the third will be one on all the extra books that I have, like Quidditch Through the Ages. I have the play also. What else? The screenplay. I have also the book that I got when I went to the studio tours. So that would be nice. Okay. So, enough of the introduction. Before I get started, these books out, I'm just going to make some nice sleepy sounds using the collection all together. Do some tracing, some tapping and scratching around the box. Just want to go to the reading and looking at the books part, I'll put a link with timelines in the description. Here we have the books. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All in different colors. Different sizes too. We have Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. One of my favorites. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. Love that one too. I love them all. Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince in orange, and Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, which is the one that is in two parts in the films. That's why there's 8 films and 7 books, and I guess that everybody knows about Harry Potter already, but just the books. I really love the fact that they get more adult as he gets more adult. Like, the themes get darker as you go along. My daughter has seen the first 2 films, and we started reading the first book. But all of this on this side is too much for her. We have J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter, and the Philosopher's Stone. I don't know if you can see the Philosopher's Stone. There we go. Just because the light wasn't hitting it. Because it's kind of like embossed and foiled. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. Some little twinkly stars. Here we have Hagrid with his little, I want to say torch, but it's not that, lantern. There we go. And we have Harry here. Hogwarts in the background. Ron, presumably, and Hermione. Then we have the boats that they used to cross over. Bloomsbury. Closer look. So yeah, I like the illustrations. It's beautiful. And on the back we have an owl delivering a letter. Okay, so your screen has switched, and that is just so that turning the envelope over, his hand trembling, Harry saw a purple wax seal bearing a coat of arms, a lion, an eagle, a badger, and a snake surrounding a large letter H. Harry Potter has never even heard of Hogwarts. When the letters start dropping on the doormat, number 4, Privet Drive, addressed in green ink on yellowish parchment with a purple seal. They are swiftly confiscated, by his grisly aunt and uncle. Then, on Harry's 11th birthday, a great beetle-eyed giant of a man called Rubeus Hagrid bursts in with some astonishing news. Harry Potter is a wizard, and he has a place at Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. An incredible adventure. Makes me want to read them again. I want to read them in French. It's like a task. Well, not a task, like a challenge I've set myself for this year. And then I'll read them in English again. For now, these copies are just for show. Green was a good choice for this book. Show you a closer look at the artwork. Do you like it? Oh, there's a little Dobby on the back with an extra large nose. Okay. There is a plot. Most terrible things happen at Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry this year. That's Dobby speaking. Harry Potter's summer has included the worst birthday ever, doomy warnings from a house elf called Dobby, and rescue from the Dursleys by his friend Ron Weasley in a magical car. That was a good bit. Back at Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry, for his second year, Harry hears strange whispers echo through the empty corridors, and then the attacks start. Students are found as though turned to stone. Dobby's sinister this is number 3, and probably I would say my favorite. I love them all, but this was probably my favorite. It has a lot of the, I don't know, like the family stuff, and just like, I don't know, there's something about this one that's probably just makes it my favorite. So J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. We have this beautiful Patronus. Then we have Harry. Then he's surrounded soul-sucking Dementors. It's beautiful. Static. So on the back is the night bus. When I went to the studio there, they have a night bus that you can go up to. Welcome to the night bus, emergency transport for the stranded witch or wizard. Just stick out your wand hand, step on board, and we can take you anywhere you want to go. It's a pretty wild ride though. When the night bus crashes through the darkness and screeches to a halt in front of him, it's the start of another far from ordinary year at Hogwarts for Harry Potter. Sirius Black, escaped mass murderer and follower of Lord Voldemort, is on the run. I like Sirius. And they say he is coming after Harry. In his first ever divination class, Professor Trelawney sees an omen of death in Harry's tea leaves. But perhaps most terrifying of all are the Dementors patrolling the school grounds with their soul-sucking kiss. Yeah, I really like this one. The Dementors are such an interesting, character. I see them as one. I like the concept is cool, and the Patronus, and I don't know, I just really like this one. So there we have number three, in a kind of icy blue. And the next one is like a powder blue. We have a beautiful fire-breathing dragon, Harry swooping by on his broom, probably his Nimbus, and then down here we have some eggs, one of which is golden. So the Goblet of Fire is a pretty good book too. Have a read. Okay, so here we have the trio, Harry, Ron, and Hermione. There will be three tasks spaced throughout the school year, and they will test the champions in many different ways. Their magical prowess, their daring, their powers of deduction, and of course, their ability to cope with danger. The Triwizard Tournament is to be held at Hogwarts. Only wizards who are over 17 are allowed to enter. But that doesn't stop Harry dreaming that he will win the competition. Then at Halloween, when the Goblet of Fire makes its selection, Harry is amazed to find his name is one of those that the magical cup picks out. He will face death-defying tasks, dragons, and dark wizards. But with the help of his best friends, Ron and Hermione, he might just face it. Okay. get on to the monster one. The big one. J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter, and the Order of the Phoenix. On a thestral, I think. Thestral. Yeah, thestral. We have Hogwarts. Oh, we have some dust. Oh no. Some dust got into my books. It's not a good sign. And this very red, orange. Blood red sunset kind of thing. It is kind of where it starts to get darker in the series. We have a snake here. Which may be one of my favorite characters. Probably is one of my favorite characters. In general. And also in the films, Alan Rickman is just amazing. I have to say that Harry is not my favorite character. I'm not really like... I don't know. Who is my favorite character? I don't know. Out of the three, probably like... Probably Ron. No, probably Hermione, then Ron, then Harry. It changes. But Harry's never been my first. You are sharing the Dark Lord's thoughts and emotions. The Headmaster thinks it inadvisable for this to continue. He wishes me to teach you how to close your mind to the Dark Lord. Snape. Dark times have come to Hogwarts. After the Dementor's attack on his cousin Dudley, Harry Potter knows that Voldemort will stop at nothing to find him. There are many who deny the Dark Lord's return, but Harry is not alone. A secret order gathers at Grimmauld Place to fight against the dark forces. Harry must allow Professor Snape to teach him how to protect himself from Voldemort's savage assaults on his mind. But they are growing stronger by the day, and Harry is running out of time. Yeah. So this is the part where everything kind of gets a bit more like adult for him. He's no longer a kid. He's more like out on his own sort of thing. Number five. Okay, let's look at number six. We have the next one is orange. J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter, and the Half-Blood Prince. Blood Prince. So here we have Great Dumbledore with his spell surrounding them, him and Harry. Here we have a little altar and some lost souls. So this is portraying that beginning of like Horcrux. Like this series, I think the artwork is cool and the colors and everything. It's lovely. a nice present. Okay. So here we have Draco Malfoy holding his arm with his very blonde hair. Okay. There it was, hanging in the sky above the school, the blazing green skull. The serpent tongue, the mark Death Eaters left behind whenever they had entered a building, wherever they had murdered. When Dumbledore arrives at Privet Drive one summer night to collect Harry Potter, his wand hand is blackened and shriveled, but he does not reveal why. Secrets and suspicion are spreading through the wizarding world, and Hogwarts itself is not safe. Harry is convinced that Malfoy bears the dark mark. There is a Death Eater among them. Harry will need powerful magic and true friends as he explores Voldemort's darkest secrets, and Dumbledore prepares him face his destiny. So yeah, it's getting pretty serious now. When we get to number 6. It's a really good one though. Okay. And here we are. Number 7, J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. And on the cover, we have Voldemort casting a spell over Harry. And here we have Nagini. I don't know if you can see, but there's someone in the shadows down here too. And here. So he's not alone. He has followers. Okay. So we have Rubeus Hagrid and Harry. Give me Harry Potter, said Voldemort's voice, and none shall be harmed. Give me Harry Potter, and I shall leave the school untouched. Give me Harry Potter, and you will be rewarded. As he climbs into the sidecar of Hagrid's motorbike and takes to the skies, leaving Privet Drive for the last time, Harry Potter knows that Lord Voldemort and the Death Eaters are not far behind. The protective charm that has kept Harry safe until now is broken, but he cannot keep hiding. The Dark Lord is breathing fear into everything Harry loves, and to stop him, Harry will have to find and destroy the remaining Horcruxes. The final battle must begin. Harry must stand and face his enemy. Though, yeah, the last one is pretty serious compared to the first one. It's a pretty big roller coaster for the people. And it's an amazing series. if you haven't read them, please do. And if you haven't seen the films, please do, if you prefer. I'm not gonna squish that in anymore. Hold on. So I just used gravity again and turned them upside down so that they all came out and pushed them all back in at the same time. So none of them got damaged. So I hope that you found this relaxing. I do love I always wanted to do a series reading Harry Potter, but I always thought, well, I don't, like, I guess you need rights to actually read the books, don't you? You can't just do, like, audiobooks and things. You need the rights to do it, so I never did. Plus, I'm sure it would take a long time. I don't know what the rules are about that, but I'm sure just showing you the books and reading the blurb is fine. That I'm sure of. Okay. I hope that you enjoy. My next one in this series will be the French ones. And then following that will be all the kind of one-off books that I have around the Wizarding universe. So to end this video, I'm just gonna do a little on the spine of the books, I guess. Just to let you guys drift off to sleep. So, I hope that you have a lovely evening. And I'll see you.